with the activities that you might find yourself in, different activities are going to give you different things that you're going to learn. The more physical the activities are that you're doing, you know, you'll learn a lot of things from that, but you're less in your mind about things. So, you know, if you really want to think about life decisions and stuff like that, you really don't want to be doing a bunch of activities that are physical. Because if you're doing a bunch of activities that are physical, you're just not going to take the time to sit there and be introspective. Now, you might be learning, you know, let's say fucking playing basketball or something. Like, I might learn a lot about the act of basketball or how important it is to, you know, release the ball at a certain spot. Like, you're going to be so tuned into the fine actions and the movements that you're doing that, you know, you're probably going to learn some awesome, cool stuff that you never really thought about, you know, before. But if you really want to go inward and learn some stuff about yourself and about your personality, then you kind of have to close your eyes and just lay down for a little bit and really just let the headspace go. And I find meditation to be just an awesome thing to do, maybe more so on the come up than anything. Because like, as your brain is shifting, it's actually really cool to observe the brain shift as it happens. Like, you can kind of see the mode switch in your brain go from the default mode network to the psychedelic mode network. I'm just make that term up. But like, it you can see kind of the switch mentally of like what's going on in your head, and you can see where your brain is like, oh shit. I'm like, I'm feeling it now, you know? And like, once you start feeling that, eventually it levels out, right? Once your body, your brain has fully switched into that mode, it is like, then I think, at least with LSD in particular, it's like smooth sailing from that point forward. Because from that point forward, it's like, you know, then it's all up to the activities you're doing and the environment you're in. But that initial shift of consciousness is sometimes uncomfortable. You know, people say like the come up is like their least favorite part. I've had trips where the come up was like 90% of the battle I fought mentally. And then after that, it was like the most fun trip of all time after. I had one where we did like two and a half tabs maybe. And I've only really done those high dosages of LSD like 3 times maybe tops. So I honestly stick usually to 1 to 2 tabs max. But in this case, I did 2.5, and I was visiting my buddy who was still at the University of Florida, but I wasn't. So I was like visiting him, and it was crazy. We like went back through the campus, and it was an amazing, just like reminiscent type experience, where at that point I basically had graduated. I hadn't officially graduated, but I moved back home and I was just taking like an online class to get my last credit. And so I went there with the intention of just having a good time with my friends who I'd missed for a few months while I was home, and to kind of reminisce on the college experience. And it was amazing. But the first like 2 hours of that shit was like overwhelming. Like, I had to just lay down. Like, we watched the LSD ASAP Rocky video, and that was super fucking trippy. And it was just like overwhelming. But then once we got through the overwhelming part and we dealt with some of the harder things that we were going through, then it was like the rest of the trip was just fun. Like, we went out and explored the campus. We walked down our old stomping grounds and places that we used to go while we were on campus there. And it was cool. It was an awesome experience. And it was very front heavy. It can be like that. It also can be, you have a great trip all up until this certain moment, and then some certain moment happens, and then it becomes really difficult. You know, you don't know what's going to trigger you, and you're in a much more sensitive state of mind. So you just have to be mindful of that. That's why you want to engage in activities that are going to be useful to you. I find listening to music is awesome. I'm such a big music person. You guys have probably gotten that from my podcast, because I've done episodes where I've literally just reviewed songs and stuff that I like. And I wish I could do that more, but copyright claim on YouTube sucks. So I get the feeling it's just not worth the hassle and the amount of times that these episodes would get taken down if I did that. So I might have to look for another way to do it. But for me, music's huge. And I like to connect with artists that really are saying something and that have a meaning. And I enjoy turn up bullshit music too. I totally do. I'm not like one of those people who can't listen to that. I actually enjoy that stuff too. But, you know, time and a place for everything. And so when I'm in that state of mind, I love listening to some music where it's like that shit touches my soul. You know, people are speaking to the heart. They're talking about like the universal love and connection that we have. And I love tapping into those things. So if I can find those things and I can listen to them while I'm on the psychedelic experience, when I'm already feeling it, you're going to feel a whole new layer to songs. You're going to hear new parts of the song that you didn't hear before. I know that there was one song where like I never noticed this like one little background ad lib thing. And now I always hear it because I noticed it on a trip. So I enjoy like closing my eyes, putting on some headphones like these where you can just like shut out the outside world. And I put on like Hans Zimmer, like Interstellar soundtrack. Dude, I fucking tripped out to that shit. That and Inception, I've like completely just like lost myself listening to those things. And it's because it's just so beautiful. It's a beautiful orchestra, beautiful arrangements. Hans Zimmer is the fucking goat. And I love listening to those stuff. So listening to good music, music that you like, you know, try to listen to music that has like some dope vibes too, you know, just like stuff you want to groove to, because you're going to want to groove more in the psychedelic state of mind. But all of those things are activities that are fun. You know, drawing, painting, if you're inclined to do those things, do those things. I love drawing on the iPad on psychedelics. It's just fun. I don't know why, ever since I got the Apple Pencil, I've just always loved doing that. And then as far as other activities, you know, going out and about. I like exploring. So, you know, going out and exploring the city was amazing. That was a whole new experience when I moved here. It was like tripping in the city. It's way different than tripping in Florida in nature. I like tripping in nature probably better than the city, but it is still like you're in awe of the buildings and the things that we've created as men and women. Sorry. I just meant that generically. But, you know, like that we created as humankind, that we made these things. And it's amazing. It really is amazing. When you look at some of the beautiful architecture here in Chicago specifically, it's breathtaking. And I've gone to museums as well. I've gone to the Art Institute here in Chicago on psychedelics. I've gone there twice on psychedelics, one on mushrooms, one on LSD. And whew, I mean, man, that shit, like you feel it. I've been transported to different timelines, you know, from the art and just like felt the pain that they felt when they painted it, you know, like it, and you know, you don't know if you're really feeling it, but it feels like that layer is still encoded in the material. It feels like the energy put into the painting itself still feels very present and palpable when you're on these substances. And I don't know if it's all an illusion or if it's like, no, it's there, but your body just normally ignores those signals because it just is too distracting in day-to-day life. I don't know. I'm not a fucking scientist. I don't know the answer. But it feels like a layer that's there. You know, when I listen to music, for example, I'll almost picture them in the booth saying the words, you know, or singing the words or whatever. And I don't know how real those visions of that is, but it feels like I'm getting the extra layer that was recorded through the audio waveforms. Embedded into the experience. And it's cool. It's like you will hear music in a different way than you never heard before. And people will say this about weed too. And I think it totally applies to weed too. Marijuana, cannabis, whatever. There is something else that you are normally not tuned into, but now you are. And it's fucking awesome, man. And not to glorify drugs, because you can get this in other states, you know, meditation, etc. But there's something about psychedelics where it gives you this preview. It lets you see what you could be. It lets you see where you could go. And it doesn't always see that, you know, it doesn't always show that to people, but if that's your intention, then it will show it to you and you'll have to work to get there. You have to then build it up and, you know, get yourself in a position to be able to do it. But it can be done.